members of the royal family strive to remain as political neutral as possible. With her blah on voter restrictions, Meghan did not openly back any candidate. Meghan and Harry could not fit the royal family because they did not want to simply become part of the royal furniture. The couple, they first say, is driven by their desire to act and to do good. The author of The Last Queen, Elizabeth II's 17-year battle to save the House of the Windsor, said, "I think Meghan's decision to write an editorial in the New York Times really won over people to vote her, and people now realize she and Harry are really trying to get works, as indeed Diana did. Harry has a very strong memory of what his mother did and what her role was, and what is there for someone like Harry? They are bringing very successful in that, I think. And they could have been a very useful influence at home." Meghan and Harry officially stepped down as senior royals on March 31st, and the couple quit their formal Sussex royal with a personal statement shared on the Instagram account. And since the spring, the couple has moved into a new home in Montecito, worked behind the scenes to the foundation all too well, and struck to a multi-million deals with streaming platforms Netflix and Spotify. Throughout the summer, Meghan and Harry have also remained in touch with organizations close to their hearts. As such, the patronage to do than to do good works. "He doesn't want to be a piece of the royal furniture. He wants to be a very positive and active person." And following Meghan and Harry's exit, the royal family have carried out several royal engagements, either in person or by video link. Earlier this month, royal panic. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry have weakened crown with US move. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's decision to step down as senior royals has weakened the crown, according to royal experts. Meghan, however, her past remarks on Donald Trump led a few royal watchers to think that she was quietly inviting US citizens to vote for Joe Biden at the polls. And over the summer, while taking part in a series of talks, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex also spoke about in depth about the focus of Archiewell, building more humane communities online and offline. In October, the couple launched a foundation website, which is at the moment presents only the name of the organization, its meaning, and the chance to register to mailing lists. Mr. Irving had previously said that Meghan's Invictus Foundation and Smart Words. And between July and September, Meghan was accused of a few royal commentators of breaking with the royal tradition by becoming royal vocal about the importance of registering to vote in US election, and has said, "As which effect makes it has that on the monarchy." The author to express.co.uk, "I think it has weakened the crown because it has basically exported them to another hemisphere. And then like a branch office of the Windsor, a separate business in US, and then in Harry split from the royal family has been described as the creation of a very successful US branch of US House of the Windsor, a royal expert claim. However, while the Duke and Duchess of Sussex appear to be thriving in California, the exodus has weakened the royal family back home." Clive Irving, a source, claimed that the Queen had given up the go-ahead of creation of what has been dubbed new firm, which sees the Queen and the seven senior royals set to work more than together from the New Year's causes they care about. And following the departure of Meghan and Harry, the main working royals left are the Queen, the Cambridges, the Princess Charles, and Kamala and Princess Anne.